All right. Good morning. You are at the Friday 6 a.m. session. Woohoo! We made it through the week. All right. I am Coach Steph. We'll roll through. We should finish with at least 10 minutes to spare, which is good. We're going to get started with the prep. We're going to do 5 minutes. We're just going to spend 1 minute on each exercise. So I'll roll through all of these exercises with you. Put 5 minutes on the clock. And then I will turn up the music. Our first one is just knee hugs. So you're just bringing your knees in. You feel a little stretch in the backs of your legs. And you just bring them into your chest. We'll do this for about 30 seconds. And then we'll switch gears just a little bit. Good. Good morning. Apparently it's not cool to be up front by the teacher. So I don't know if you want to be up here. Just teasing, I don't mind. All right, we're going to switch gears a little bit. We're going to do heel pulls. So you bring your heel up to your bottom and make sure you get a nice stretch in your quad. Just rolling through both. I was just teasing. You could be in the back if you wanted to. It's okay. I was wondering, I was like, is there... Here's Dolly, woohoo. All right, we're gonna switch gears again. We're gonna go from a downward dog into a cobra. So I'm in like a V shape, nice stretch, and then I push forward and look up at the ceiling. After yesterday's ab work, you should feel nice stretch. And then we go back into that downward dog, into the cobra again. Good morning, Dolly. Good. We're about like a minute and a half into the stretch. We're just doing 1 minute of each one. So we're starting with a downward dog, moving into that cobra. Good, less than 15 seconds. Now 10 more seconds. All right, we're gonna come up to standing. We've got alternating step back lunges. So just coming back down, touching that back knee to the floor as if you didn't do enough lunges yesterday. If you were here, do a whole bunch more. Good. About 20 more seconds of these. One more each side. We're going to switch gears, moving into mountain climbers, but they are slow. So I'm in a tall plank, keep my butt down. And just slowly bring my knees in. We're here for a full minute, so take your time. About 30 more seconds. Good, about 5 more seconds. All right, we're gonna come up to standing. Last part, just a little bit of cardio. That 1-2-1 shuffle, or if you don't like the shuffle, you can do seal jacks. So you pick whichever one you'd like to do. Good. We just keep rolling through for the last minute. I'm gonna switch the two slides. All right, about 30 more seconds. There we go. Cool. Good. About 10 seconds. Three, two, one, and rest. All right. So let's talk about format for this next part. We'll have two groups going because we have just over enough racks and bars for the people who are in the session. So two rounds, there's two different sets. No matter what, it's 10 minutes. So if you are already around the rack, you will work on squats and heavy ropes for 10 minutes. And if you are over here by where the benches are, you can pull the bench into your box. You're gonna work here for 10 minutes and then we'll swap, quick 2 minute transition, and then we'll move to the other side. Okay, so that if you're at the squats, now you'll move to upper body. If you're doing upper body work, you go to the squats. Let's talk about the first set. So everything is three rounds, no matter what. If you are squatting on a scale of 1 to 10, you'll probably start at like a 7, but you're doing 12 squats. So you don't wanna lift quite as heavy. This is not max out day. You can ramp up your weight though. So you start off at a 7, you do 12 squats, you feel good. Add on some weight for the next round, still feeling good, add on some weight. We do want you to add weight throughout so that as you get to that last round, that last set of 12, you're tired, you might need a spot. By all means, flag me down. I will come over and spot you on those last couple, okay? Squat form. So real quick, if I'm walking into the bar, Michelle's is actually a little high for me. Sorry, Michelle, I'm gonna go to this one. So when I walk in, you wanna have the same form every time when you walk in for a squat. So this way you're comfortable. So usually I step in, set my hands, go under. This is even a little high for me. So make sure that that bar is set at a comfortable height. I always put it on the meaty part of my back, never directly against my spine, my neck, and not too low that my shoulders are pulling back. Okay, meaty part of the spine. And then I lift up. Again, that one's a little high. I would probably lower the clamps. Step out. My feet are a little wider than hip distance. Okay, elbows underneath, sitting down and back. You have 12. Okay, so just make sure that you have that same setup each time. What I talked about in the last session was you have three rounds. What sometimes happens is for that last round, people panic. They have like a minute left. Say real quick, run under. They don't really have good form. They step out and they just start like cranking out squats. I'd rather you take your time, okay? Really get into position. There are 12 of them, okay? So make sure feet are set, that you're comfortable before you go to sit down. If you're not, re-rack, put it back up, try again, set, and then step back so you're nice and comfortable. If you need to go over the 10 minutes, that's fine. If you need to skip a few reps, if you only get to 6, that's fine. But rather you have good form, it's all set up properly, than you cranking out 12 reps in like the last minute. It just gets a little crazy. So 12 squats, and then you do 20 heavy ropes, heavy jump ropes. If you don't want to use the heavy jump rope, there's smaller jump ropes on the side. You would do 40 single unders with the regular rope. Okay, so more, I know. Sorry. You just go back and forth between the two. So three rounds, squat, rope, squat, rope, squat, rope, okay? If you are not doing that, then we are up here in the front. We are doing dumbbell chest presses. So what I talked about with this, for those who are in the front, normally if we did floor presses, because you have the floor to kind of stop you, I would go heavy. Like I'd probably do 35s because you just have the floor. What's the worst that happens if it's too heavy? Drop them. Don't drop them on yourself, but like drop them on the floor. This is harder because you're going below like a floor level. You're not stopping. Your elbows go a little bit lower. So my weight is just a little bit lower. So keep that in mind. When I sit back, make sure my feet are flat on the floor. My arms are not directly out to my sides. They're not like shoulders and they're not directly next to my sides either. They're at a slight angle, push and down, push and down. And I talked about this too. Few people in here have done body pump before. Okay. I used to teach body pump and we always said, press your back against the bench. You don't have to. Okay. You can have a little bit of an arch and you can use some momentum to press it we used to tell you not to do that because you were doing 5 minutes of chest exercises. Here, you're going to do 3 sets of 12. So you can have a little bit of arch to kind of help you gain momentum to press that up. So 12 chest presses going up and down. Then I'm going to slide up my bench just a little bit. We're doing pullovers. So I make a diamond with my hand, hold that dumbbell overhead, and go back and up. Same thing, I can have a little bit of an arch in my back. And I'll be honest, I probably would use 30s for this for the press, but I could probably go up a little bit for the dumbbell pullover to like a 35 or a 40. So you can get 3 dumbbells if you need them, if you need an extra one, just pulling back and over. We did skull crushers earlier where we were bending the elbows. Don't bend the elbows. Everything is straight, straight back and up. And then one more move, that bench dip. So my hands, palms face down, fingers are forward. I stay close to my bench and I go down and up. We're working the triceps. Okay, so keep those, the elbows facing straight back. Don't let them kind of move out to the sides. Then you start to use your biceps a little bit. It's not where we want to focus today. So just keeping my butt close to the bench and my elbows straight back. Okay. So if you are squatting, I'm going to put 2 minutes on the clock for you to kind of build up your weight a little bit and so that I could talk to the people at home. And if you were in the front, you're grabbing 2 dumbbells for press and you might even need a third for pullovers. Okay. So 2 minutes on the clock. Ha ha. I knew that was going to happen. And then I'll talk to you guys at home. All right. So for you, you have... Neither of you have a bar. Goblet squats. I know it's not fun. I'm sorry, because we do goblet squats a lot. Do you have like a heavy kettlebell? And if you don't, or if you want to do 2 dumbbells, that's fine. Just trying to get that motion, you know. Heavier, lean more towards 12. If you've got lightweights, I'll be honest, I find it easier to put a front rack. Like if you have 2 dumbbells, if you'd rather do that, because that's a much more similar to what we're doing in here. If you want to front rack it and still squat, that's fine too, with 2 dumbbells. And then you'll do, he said 60 jump ropes or penguin hops, but then he told me specifically, if they're not doing the heavy rope, to just do 40. So it's your option. You can do, I mean, it's a big difference. You can do 40 or 60. It's Friday. If you're sore, do 40. If you're feeling it and you're like, I'm going to push myself, by all means, do 60. Okay. Do you have any questions? It's still 10 minutes and it's still 3 rounds. Okay, cool. And then I'll give you the upper body stuff next. Cool. All right. Good. Okay. I'm going to put 10 minutes on the clock and you may get started. It's 3 total rounds. Almost everything is sets of 12 except those rope jumps. So whether heavy rope is 20 and a regular rope is 40. All right, I will walk around and check on everybody. Good, ladies. But we're getting low. They're heavy. Oh, man. Good. I see you're both green and yellow. Good. Good work, ladies. Good work, ladies. Looks good. I am cleaning them up, right? Yes. There it is. I would just rest them there, just making sure they don't fall. And then just, yep. It's hard to hold in that goblet position. Sometimes Joe takes it and he puts it behind his neck. Have you seen him do that? And it's just a little easier. Just hard on your chest to hold it up. But we're not focusing on front squats. It's just the weight itself. So they look good, Dolly. That was good, Joanna. Good. We have just over 5 minutes, so you should be at least into round two, if not finishing up round two. Good work, ladies. Yes. Dolly, you got nice low squats. Good form. We're at the 2.5 minute mark, so you are definitely on round three. If you're finishing up, if you can wipe down your equipment with those plates, if you're squatting, just wipe down with a dry paper towel. You don't need to spray them. They're starting to get a little rusted. Please do spray down your bar, though. And same thing with the upper body equipment, the dumbbells, and the bench, if you can wipe them down when you're done. All right, so we're finishing up, less than a minute left. All right, so ladies at home, I'm gonna switch your screen. Sorry if there's a male who's watching the replay. I keep saying ladies, but there's only ladies who hopped on the workout, so you're gonna have to hear me say ladies, sorry. All right. Okay. All right, so now we're switching gears and you are in the press, the pullover, and the dips, just like I explained. Joanna's got a bench, so same thing, Joanna. I would go slightly lighter for a bench press, dumbbell bench press, than I would a floor press, just because you can't drop to the floor. But 12 presses, 12 pullovers, and 12 dips, okay? No dips on it. Yes, that is fine. If you want to, in here, I'm going to put 2 minutes to transition. If you can wipe down your equipment. If you were squatting, come on over to the bench. If you were on the bench, you're going to the squats. And please make sure you have some warm-up sets. Don't just throw on all the weight. Yeah, if you want to do instead, it's kind of like that pullover. But if you have the, this isn't fun. Yes, I say a tricep extension. They're not fun, but yeah. And it might even be easier because sometimes it's hard to hold it that way. Crushing it and then going back is just a little easier. Just make sure your elbows face forward. If they start to sneak out, you're using biceps a little bit, okay? But cool. All right, so sets of 12 for you. I'm gonna go around and make sure everybody in here is okay. How you doing, Dolly? Your squat depth was really good. I could see that because you're sideways. It's hard for me to tell on Joanna because she's facing, but you're sideways. So cool. All right. Whatever bench you like to, you can use this one. Yep. I'm just going to grab this dumbbell unless you want to use a 15. Actually, you might want to use 15s. You want to try 15s? Your mom did 20. You can do 15. Not to make it a competition, but I'm just saying your mom did 20. So here, try the movements with 15s. All right. All right. Oh, we lost my MyZone belt. I don't know what happened. I'm in here. Okay. Well, okay. Yeah, of course. Yeah. No. I'll hold the bar. Yeah. I always err on the side of lower, which there's a whole school of thought that I shouldn't do that because then I've got to lift it up, but I'd rather be lower and then just slam it into the rig and be done. Yes, I'd rather just go boom rather than trying to lift up onto my calves. Yeah, okay. All right, so we should be almost ready. You have plenty of time. If you're squatting and you're just starting to warm up or you've just started to add weight, that's fine. You've got plenty of time for 10 minutes, three rounds. So 10 minutes on the clock whenever you are ready. Remember, everything is sets of 12 except for those rope jumps. All right, so whenever you are ready, you can get started. Sets of 12 for everything. Nice, Dolly. So you're using core because you're holding the bench in front of you with your heels and you're doing tricep dips. This is pretty crazy. It's just not high enough. If your table is too high, I know you can't go as low. You could put weights on your legs to just make it a little bit harder because you can't do the range of motion. So you can make it harder by making it heavier. Does that make sense? Like putting dumbbell on your leg or something? Just to kind of help you because I'm watching you with that, the stool, and it was moving. Please don't die. Okay. Looks good though. Go work, go work. So we have 3.5 minutes left. We should be somewhere around round three, okay? So if you're finishing up round two, you got a little bit of time, but somewhere close to round three. Good, ladies. I know those tricep dips are tough. And staying, the closer you get to it, the more you're focusing on the tricep. That's tough. Good presses, Joanna. Yes. Time check, just under 90 seconds. So we should be finishing up round three. If you do finish round three, if you can wipe off your equipment, strip the weights off the bars, dumbbells go back, that would be great. Thank you. All right, ladies at home, I'm gonna switch your screen. Just one more time. All right, so as you finish up, if you can wipe down the equipment you've used, we're gonna pull the benches out of the squares. Good, so we're finishing up, wiping down equipment, and we'll move to the next part. I'm going to pull this out of your square so that. All right, so we're wiping down that equipment. Good. Move your bench for you. Okay. All right, so for the next part, you will need two plates. Ladies, if you want to grab two small metal plates, weight recommendations are up there. It's mostly a lot of shoulder work, a little bit of pec work as well. Weight recommendations, it's two plates. So for women on the heavier end, like higher end, it's 2 10-pound plates, but I would still grab these two metal plates. For men, you can grab 10s or 15s, and Silas swears you could do this with bumper plates. My hands are not big enough, and I'm only 5'2", so it won't work for me, but by all means, you can. First move, plate pinch press. So I put my hand wide on each side of the plates, and I'm going to hold them together. And I'm pushing out and in, or I push up and in. And where you're going to feel it is all along the top of your pecs, okay? So really squeezing and pushing. At home, if you don't have two plates and you have a dumbbell, it's just that crush press straight forward and out, okay? But if you have two plates, Joanna, yeah, by all means, pinch them together and then either out or you can go up just a little bit, but you've got 12, or no, you've got 15, I'm sorry. Last one was sets of 12. So 15 pinch presses, then slip your thumbs through the holes and you've got front raises. We did front raises on Saturday. And the one big thing that I saw a lot of people do is it starts to either arch their back or they went too high. You just need shoulder height and try not to use your hips to throw the weight forward. We're just doing, it's a small movement. If you're struggling to get the weight up, drop down a little bit. That's okay. So 15 front raises and then 15 side raises. Just make sure elbows and wrists are the same height. What we got at the end was a lot of like pterodon, like flapping wings kind of going. Elbows and wrists at the same time. Again, if it's too hard, drop your weight just a little bit, but everything should be in line at the top. Okay, does that make sense? So 15, 15, and 15. I'm going to put 10 minutes on the clock. Almost everyone finished within the 10 minutes. It makes sense if you almost, you don't have to go every minute on the minute, but you could and you would finish in time. 15 of one, do 15 of the next minute, and then 15 of the third, okay? So grab two plates. Again, you can grab the small plates. I would grab, yep, two and make sure we do pinch, front, and sides. All right. 10 minutes on the clock. All right, whenever you are ready. I'll turn it up a little bit. Yes, good. I know you're holding a Joanna around to kind of secure it. Don't secure it. It's really about squeezing and yes, yes. Because you're wrapping your fingers around, but that's giving you security and you're not squeezing as hard as you can. Really flatten those hands. I know, it's hard to do. 15 of them. Yep. It might be easier if you flip it so that. Good. So as you move to those front raises, everything stays stable. We're not using hips. This is not a swing. So everything is stable. Just the arms move just to shoulder height and then down. Yes. Good, Dolly. Yes. Yes, Joanna. Good. Good side raises. Oh, look at you with that banded landmine press. Nice. There it is. Good. Yep. See you. I'm hanging out here to see what you're typing. Oh, yeah. No. 20 pounds. So in here, I have good form on everything with 2 5-pound plates. I do not have as good form with 2 10-pounds. So what we started to do in the last session, like Stephanie and Laura put a 5 and a 2.5, and that was okay. It's like this perfect, but if you only have a 20-pound dumbbell, don't push. Yeah. Good. So we're just under the 5-minute mark, somewhere around round 2 or 3. There you are. You look bored. You're like, So if you're watching the replay, you can't see Dolly because you'll only see me, but she's got 2 of these little dumbbells and she's just going like this. Like she's, you're cracking me up. And these light pink dumbbells as well. I'm sorry. I'm loving this. It cracks me up. For the record, Dolly can like squat over 200 pounds. So like, yeah, there we are. Thank you for making my Friday morning. We have about 3 minutes left. So again, approaching round 3 or just finishing up. Now Joanna's just showing off doing handstands over there. Can you do a push-up? Handstand push-up? No. That'd be tough. That elbow, yeah. That's fair. All right. As you finish up, if you can wipe down the plates again, you don't have to spray the plates. They're all starting to get a little rusty. So if you can just wipe them down with a dry paper towel and then put them back. We've got two stretches. So the first one is a pec stretch. I like to do these over at the rig. So kind of like that banded pec stretch that we did earlier this week. Put my hand, my arm about shoulder level, and I'm going to move so that I'm twisting a little bit, but where I'm getting a stretch is it's nice and long across my arm and my pec. The key is not shoving my shoulder forward. It's extending so that I get a stretch. I'm just leaning slightly forward to get a stretch through all the way through the pec. About 30 seconds on one arm and then 30 seconds on the other. Just a slight stretch. And again, preventing that shoulder from shoving forward. So 30 seconds on each arm for a pec. And then we've got a couch stretch, which is just that front squat quad stretch. So curl one toe under, lean forward about 30 seconds. So I know some people are finishing up. That's fine by all means. If you're doing the couch stretch, make sure you get that stretch up your front quad. If you'd like to, we can extend the same arm that with the leg that's down and you can twist in towards your knee a little bit. Just extends the stretch a little bit. Good. And if you're finishing up plate work, that's fine too. Good. Good. And you only go as far as you feel the stretch. So good. So if you're going to use your arm for the couch stretch, same arm as the leg that's down and you're leaning in towards your knee. Good. It was good work today. Good. So about 30 seconds on each pec and then 30 seconds for each leg for the couch stretch. If you are joining us tomorrow, Coach Nick will be here on Saturday. So just let us know. But otherwise, I'm going to turn off the recording. Hopefully we will see you tomorrow.